Most Asian stocks fell on Wednesday as mixed corporate earnings, China's COVID troubles, and more aggressive rate hikes dimmed the growth outlook, sapping the mood. Also a dampener, the overnight drop of the tech-heavy Nasdaq to a fresh low in 2022. Chinese stocks, though, managing to reverse earlier losses thanks to data showing industrial profits rose 8.5% in the first quarter of the year, holding up despite fresh COVID outbreaks. Here at home, Philippine shares among the laggards of the day, with the index falling 1.7% back to the 6,800 level. Decliners beating advancers almost 3-1. Volume was up nearly 9 billion pesos. This includes the block sale of A-REIT shares in relation to its 3.5 billion peso property for share swap deal with Ayala Land. In corporate stories, Aboitiz Equity Ventures more than halved its earnings in the first quarter of the year, dragged by its power unit, its biggest contributor, which saw profit drop 53%. Also dragging the numbers for its power unit, extraordinary numbers such as liquidated damages, business interruption claims, Typhoon Odette, and advanced outages. This is also the first quarter that reflects its smaller stake in Aboitiz Power from 77% to 52% as a result of its partnership with Japan's JERA. Meanwhile, Union Bank also posted a 45% drop in earnings, citing the absence of extraordinary gains from 2021. On the bright side, though, net interest income went up 12% thanks to higher yields in earning assets and lower cost of funding. Fee-based income also grew on the back of higher InstaPay and interchange fees. Loan loss provisions also down 78%. Meanwhile, Pilmico's agribusiness segment suffered from forex losses from the devaluation of the Sri Lankan rupee. On the other hand, Republic Cement turned in a net loss of 18 million pesos from a profit of nearly 900 million due to lower demand for cement because of the increase in prices of steel and other construction materials. The only unit that actually saw growth is Aboitiz Land. Michelle Long, ABS-CBN News.